Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing an overview of soul boosting, increasing the character's stats, and attaching items. Depending on how long that goes, we might also do a team building. If not, I'll do a separate team building video. So let's go ahead and jump into it. First off, these are the characters. We're going over here. We're underneath the character list. Actually, we'll just start from the beginning. Go over here, hit the menu, go to characters, and this is your list of characters. Now you can do different things. You have equipment upgrades, equipment, character list, and soul boosts, right? So right now what we want to do, I want to go over soul boosting with you first and foremost, because I feel like that's the most important topic that everyone's probably watching this video for. So soul boosting is when you take a character and you make them more powerful. It also allows you to ascend them to a higher level. So you go over here like this Goku, I have that level 600, right? I go and hit confirm, and now I want to soul boost him. I have class up, and then you have all the different tree. In order for your class to go up, you need to increase it to the specified amount. This is 20, so you need 20 of 20. So that means I have to have at least 20 of the soul trees unlocked before I can go in here. And when you do the soul tree, it's going to tell you what exactly you need in order to increase it. As you see over here, I clicked on strike defense. You have strike defense up here, and it tells you on the left-hand side what you actually need. You could actually click on how to get. When you click on how to get, if you need a rising soul, you can go and you could select the level you want to do. Typically, the higher the level, the higher the drop rate. Typically, we're going to go over that in a minute too. And then you also have rising soul too. So you just scroll through and it tells you of what item you need, where to find it. You could actually click on the little play button and it'll bring you directly to the level that you selected. But anyway, we already have Goku a class 20 of 20, so we want to go and level him up right now so we can get to 1,000. As you see over here, this requires when you go actually to make him go to a higher level, like level 300 to 600, 600 to 1,000, it requires super souls. 300 to 600 requires super soul 1s, and then 600 to 1,000 requires super soul 2s. So you need to go in here and you need to select that. I already have the items, obviously. So I'm going to go over here. I hit class up, hit OK. And it's going to say, are you sure you want to use all these items? These are the items that's going to be required. Tells you the class up, the effect, the max level, fighter 600 to 1,000, equipment slots. You can now hold two pieces of equipment, and how much Zenny you're going to require. So we're going to go ahead. We're going to soul boost this SOB. Now he's classed up. Now he went from fighter to adept. So now I have two adept fighters and he can go up to level 1000. Going to level 1000 at this point in the game, it is currently middle of June in 2018. So if you're watching this far in the future, a lot could have changed. But right now we can only go up to level 1000. As you see over here, there's nothing in the middle, so you can't ascend him any farther. At some point we will most likely be able to, but as of right now, you can't. So let's go actually back real quick. And I also want to show you, so this is my Nappa. I don't have him ascended whatsoever. He has class 0 of 10, and I have enough to actually ascend him. I think I have enough to actually ascend him. So I'm going to go over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to start with 5. I'm going to hit OK. It's going to send him up with a soul boost. And there we go. Now you're going to go down here, and you're going to see the class up is now 5 of 10. I need to get 5 more unlocked. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just so you know, most characters, almost all of them, I'm pretty sure every single one of them in-game right now, if you just complete this first line of row up, and you hit OK, you can then ascend them up to level 600. You don't need to do it with all your characters. I myself am just doing it to all my extreme and sparking characters. I'm not doing it to anyone else, unless it's like a requirement. But see, I have my my souls that I need, my super soul ones and my rising soul ones. So I'm going to go over here. I'm going to hit ascend. And now he's going to get ready to ascend to level 600. Now, also, the reason why I'm doing this is we have that special campaign, the thank you campaign. And if you get characters up to level 6, you get more super soul tools, super soul 2s, and they have a ridiculous drop rate. Now, I did want to say, I want to shout out to the Reddit and shout out to Gamely.jp. Let's go over here to my Chrome session real quick. And you can see over here on Chrome, we have the drop rate. So this is Gamely.jp. Never heard of this before. I actually got it from the Reddit. So shout out to the Dragon Ball Legends Reddit, as I mentioned in my Dragon Ball Legends overview. This is where you have the best drop rates for the Super Soul 2s. Right now, it's really like the highest level pretty much. Except for 111 on hard, I guess that's interesting, 5% drop rate for the blue ones, for the agility ones, 8% for 112 on hard, and almost 5% on 113 on hard. So that's pretty interesting. I actually need to go look into that hard versus normal, because I wasn't sure I wasn't aware that that's a thing right now. look at that, we're learning on the fly. And you also have different drop rates here for different pieces and everything like that, for what's going to drop on the different levels. So go over here, shout out to Gamey.jp. You can get more information about it from here. It's all in Japanese, so you have to use Google Translate, which always isn't the best. But you can go ahead and find out that information there. Anyway, back over to the game. So we're over here now, and that's pretty much it for the characters. Now, we have different abilities, items that you could attach to a character. I do need to state each team, right? Now, this is my sparking team, I call it, you know, air quotes, sparking team. So I have all these units up here. I can go in and I could change the equipment and what I could attach them. Like my Vegeta, I have ascended almost to level 1,000. I could attach another item to him if I want to. And I could hit confirm. But when I go over here, now let's go back and let's switch over to my Saiyan boost team, right? Change equipment. Vegeta now only has one item on it because that's the only thing I attached to him earlier. So every single team, you could equip different equipment to it. So you could actually set a team, like let's say you have a whole bunch of defensive boost items, right? So you want to make a defensive team. You can call it team defense or something like that. And you can give them all different items. Then you can go over here to party three, change the equipment, right? And you could select different items. When you go to a different team, all of your items, all the items that were available on the last team are available again to you. So it's not like they get used up per team, which is very, very useful. So you definitely want to take that into consideration when you're building your teams, that you don't have to worry about using the items like that. In terms of equipment or items, you have a whole list of equipment over here. Actually, I'm on filter right now. So one, two, I have it on all of them. There we go. So now this is all the items that you have. Typically with items, and I know if you guys have watched other people's videos, they've probably gone pretty in-depth with this. You can go into these items and you can look at them. Let's see, equipment. And you can actually figure out what the heck they are. You click on it and it tells you what it is. So this is Piccolo's getting killed. Stay alive, Gohan. Base strike attack plus 5.8%. It's at level 1. Equipment condition character tag is Piccolo, so it could only be equipped to Piccolo. This will increase his strike by 5.8%. Now, the interesting thing about that is you go through, obviously, there's not, there is another one over here. Click on that 6.6%. When you get the drops from the actual items, you need to select which one has the best drop. Now, because it's for Piccolo specifically, this one, you're just going to look for the best and you can go and sell. So this one's 6.6. And I don't think I have any more. Although we do have some more over here. So that's 7.5. I like that one the best so far. That's 9.2. So that one's actually the best. The further I go down, I'm finding better and better. Okay, so this one is the best one that I could actually have. So we're going to favorite that one. But now, keep this into consideration, too. This is just finding the best base that you could have. Let me unfavorite this real quick. So, that's the best one for the base stats, right? Now, these are the items, and you're pretty much going to do the same thing. You click on any item, it's going to tell you what the conditions are, if there are any. So, this has to be Super Warrior, so, like, it's going to be Yamcha, Tien, stuff like that. Level 1, and you could ascend the levels. And pretty much, you just go through. This one is a green tag, so only green elements can hold it. Blast defense and whatnot. You go back, and we're going to equipment upgrade, right? Now, I'm just going to show you two different equipment upgrades. We're going to go down and we're going to do it to both the Piccolo cards, right? So this one is what? I think we talked about this was 9.2 and this one is 7.05, right? So let's go ahead and upgrade this SOB. Upgrade. It requires some items as well. So now this one gets a base blast defense of 7.2. That's pretty awesome, right? Then we go over here. We're going to upgrade it again. And look, it requires some more of those items. And it requires 20,000 Zenny. And now it also has a base key restore speed of plus 6.95. Damn, that's actually a really good freaking roll right there, actually. So right now, then we'll go ahead and we'll click on it. And we see the slots, the different slots of what is going to be used. So these are all the things that will happen that can increase your character's abilities. Now we go over here to this Piccolo, right? He has a lower base stat. So now look at that. Base blast defense plus 9%. So don't go and just toss it away if it's a little bit lower. You can go and upgrade, and the secondary abilities on these items can actually be better than the ones with a better base stat. So now let's go over here and let's take a look, right? So that's 7, 9.5, and 6. And that's 9, 7.5, and 7. So you have different abilities here. This one has a better blast defense, and this guy who has blast defense of 7.25. Base key restore speed is 7, which is definitely better than this of 6. So just because it has a better initial stat, don't just go and write it off as it's going to be a crappy item. It's very cheap to go and upgrade your items, and you might be able to utilize them for different scenarios. Obviously, if you're looking for the best of the best, you're going to want to go and get a whole bunch of them. Make sure the slot one has a high whatever percentage it is, and then go and upgrade it until you get the one specific item that's super high. I mean, I'm not going to go that anal about it, but you can definitely do that. And then you can go over and you could attach it to any character that you want. This one specifically is Piccolo. So we're going to go over to my Piccolo. I think I have him on my Sparking. Yep. So we're going to change equipment over here. We're going to go over to Piccolo and we're going to change that item. Because I think, what's this item over here? This is Blast Defense, Blast Attack, Special Move Damage. So that's up, as you see, 8, 9, and 3.6. So that's not horrible. We can go ahead and if I wanted to, I can go switch it over to the Piccolo that I have over here. He is a little bit better, so we'll go do that, and then there we go. Now I have this Piccolo up over here, and he is now attached. I like the key restore speed a little bit better, so that's just my thing. I can go ahead and I could hit confirm, and now he's there. Once I ascend him past, I'll have two slots that I could attach, like I did with the Vegeta, like I could do with the Goku right now. And when you look over here, if it can't be attached to him, it will be X'd out. That's what all those little X's are. So I can go over here and I can just select something else that I want and I can attach it. I don't know what the heck this nap is, actually. Let's see, what is he again? Base strike defense, so I can go ahead and I could select that for him if I really wanted to. And then, I'd have to upgrade it, obviously. That way I can get it a little bit, make the item a little bit more useful for Goku. Because I don't want him to just, you know, be all screwy, you know, and just have a crappy-ass item. So base strike attack plus 5%, and then that's actually really freaking nice. 5% attack to strike. And special move damage only 3.4, but that's not bad. I got a Z mission from it as well, and that's pretty much how you're setting up your items and your soul boosting. You know, you need those items for soul boosting. You need those items for ascending your items, your equipment, and that's how you're gonna attach it. Now, obviously, you're gonna base it off of the type of team you're building. I'm 11 minutes into this video, so I want to talk about team building in a separate video. So that's it for this video, guys. Let me know if that was helpful and informative. It's pretty simple. It's pretty straightforward. Right now, the game is very simple, so it's very easy for me to go over everything in detail, and I'll go over more as it goes out. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.